celebrate, we think of a reading speaking about the saint. And today we do hear about St. Jude in the Gospel reading. We also hear about him in the context of 11 other people. And I was kind of thinking, well, can't we just have a reading just about him and skip all the other names? I was going to ask Deacon Faustine just to skip over all the names and just say Jude Thaddeus. But then I wouldn't be correct. But, you know, I found myself kind of thinking about what does that mean? You know, the fact that the reading we have today for our patron saint, it includes 11 other people. And, you know, one could look at it one way going, gosh, you know, we should have our time in the sun, you know? On the other hand, we could look at that and recognize that with St. Jude, even his feast day is with St. Simon, that he journeys with other people. Maybe the message we receive today with our patron saint, with our gospel reading, hearing of the 11 other apostles, and knowing that he shares the feast with another saint who also gave his life for the faith, that we have this wonderful message about St. Jude, this message about him journeying and working with other people. And what a wonderful message that is for you and I today. As we gather here and celebrate the feast of our patron saint, we gather here and we have an opportunity to be reminded that we journey with other people, that we're not alone in our journey, that as we embrace Jesus, as we take up our crosses and follow in his footsteps, we have the privilege, the honor, and the opportunity to journey with other people. We're not alone in our journey. As I was, you know, as we were coming in today with an extra number of altar servers and of course having extra priests and extra deacons, this wonderful message to remind ourselves that we journey together. I couldn't help, as I mentioned earlier, to think that it's been just over 4 years that we dedicated our new church. And I was thinking about the fact that 4 years ago, doesn't seem that long ago for me, you know? It just seems like yesterday. But the fact that 4 years ago to today, we've been blessed to have two more deacons join our parish, Deacon Faustine and Deacon Bruce. We've been blessed to have one of our own ordained from our parish, Deacon Sal. I was thinking, wow, 4 years, a lot happened, you know? And then I was thinking of our blessed to have our pastor emeritus with us, Father John Conway. And I was thinking of the fact that if I got it correct, you came here in 1992. 91, got that wrong, sorry. 1991, really? Wow. 1991, so I even had it totally wrong. I was thinking of when he came here in 1991 to 2015, I was just thinking about, you know, where the rest of us were. I was still up in Oregon, you know? I wasn't even ordained a priest. You know, how amazing that is, the journey we all take. And, of course, there was other people here. It wasn't just Father Conway by himself. And I think that's the amazing thing as you think about it, we all journey with other people. We journey together. And St. Jude today with our readings, he can be giving us this message that we are journeying with each other. And be it from 1991, be it in 2015, or when we dedicate our new church in 2011, we're all journeying together. And each one of us has special gifts and talents to share with each other. And each one of us has a special call from God. St. Jude had his call, and he shows us the way. It was in the Middle Ages that he became known as the Saint of Hopeless Causes, and a great devotion developed around him for that. And I'm not sure if, when I was sent here in 2007, I pointed out to the Archbishop at the time, Archbishop Sheen, I said, well, you are aware that St. Jude is the patron saint of hopeless causes. He says, yes, I'm clearly aware of that. I'm not sure if all Archbishop Sanger said that to you when he sent you here, Father. But anyhow, the wonderful thing is having a saint that it is that people respond to so often. That, you know, no matter what challenges we have St. Jude who so often scholars would say that he became known as the saint of hopeless causes because people confused him with the one who betrayed Christ, rather Judas Iscariot, and they would confuse his name with his. And so it was kind of a hopeless cause that people would figure it out. But the
The wonderful thing is St. Jude never gave up. He continued to share the good news with others, and he gave his life the faith that you and I are privileged to have. And so may we never give up, and may we always turn to a saint of hopeless causes, and to know that in the eyes of God we are never hopeless. And may we know that there is always hope as we take up our crosses and follow Christ.